Welcome to our demonstration of UW Connect Lite for ticketing. UW Connect Lite provides an easy way for you to track and manage customer requests and inquiries. By defining your own categories and assignment groups, you support the efficient routing of tickets to subject matter experts. And by creating ticket templates and knowledge articles, your team will be able to respond more quickly to your customers. You can easily share solutions across your staff, and this supports onboarding and also helps in providing coverage when key staff are out of office. Your customers can view the ticket status and provide updates on their UW Connect My Request page. This is the same place where they can find issues logged with other UW Connect service providers, such as UW IT and the Integrated Service Center. For our demonstration, we're going to be working with a fictional department, which is called UW Event Management. They provide support for UW administrators who are coordinating conferences, online workshops, and seminars. The customer, in this case, is Lisa, and she sent an email to the department's published email address asking for assistance. She CC'd her boss, Mary. A ticket has been generated and routed to the department. We're going to take a look at how the resulting ticket is handled in UW Connect from initial handling through to resolution. We're currently logged in as a very fortunately named person whose name is UW Connect Lite user. She's taking a look at her group's active work. She sees that there are 3 new tickets. There's a high priority one. 15 tickets are currently in progress, and 1 is recently resolved. She sees that there are a few records that have not yet been assigned for follow-up, and so she's going to take a look. She finds the ticket that was created from Lisa's email and drills down into it. You can see that the subject line of Lisa's email was mapped to the short description field, and the body was mapped to the longer description field. Lisa shows as the opened for person, and Mary, who was CC'd, has been added to the watch list. It shows the contact type as being email, and by default, we set to general inquiry and to our event coordination assignment group. UW Connect Lite user isn't actually able to answer this question. She needs to forward it on to somebody else for follow-up. She's gonna tweak the short description so that it's something a little bit more meaningful, and she's gonna tighten up the fuller description. Don't worry though, the information that was originally submitted is available in the history tab. She assigns this record to Faison. She's interested in learning about what happens with this ticket, so she adds herself to the internal notes list. This ticket is now in Faison's queue and ready for him to work on. So now we can take a look at Faison's perspective. We're logged in as Faison, and he is looking at a dashboard that's showing him his active work. You can see that he has 1 new ticket assigned to him, and that is the issue that UW Connect Lite user just forwarded on. He takes a look at this. This is actually an issue that he's answered a number of times before, and he even has a template that has some predefined content to send to the customer. When he applies the template, the content went into this field called Comments Customer Visible. He's going to tweak this a little bit, personalize it for Lisa. And then when he saves this record, the content of that field is going to be sent via email to Lisa and Mary and will also be visible on the My Requests page. We'll take a look at My Requests in a little bit. Faizan is going to set the state of this to resolved, as in his experience, the information he sent is enough to answer Lisa's questions. He'd actually like other people in the organization to be able to provide the same type of information, and he's asking the UW Connect Lite user to create a knowledge article with the information that's included in this ticket. That'll make it available to others in our event management organization. Now note he's entering the information into this field called work notes. Whereas the above content, once this record is saved, will go to Lisa and Mary, the work notes comment is only going to go to UW Connect Lite user because that person is on the contact or on the work notes list. Let's take a closer look at dashboards. Again, we're logged in as the UW Connect Lite user. She's looking at a dashboard that's showing her organization's work, both active and historical information. And then if there were knowledge articles, those would be on the third tab. We've already seen the overview type of data on top, such as new records, high priority tickets. And then we've also seen how to find unassigned work. The active work also allows you to view active records by assignment group, by category, and very importantly, by aging. We can see here we have a lot of records that are active and more than 50 days old. We should probably take a look at those. Additionally, we have trending information for this organization, which gives you a high-level overview of when they are having high or low call volume. Now, UW Connect Lite user has access to three dashboards. One, for work assigned to her. Two, work assigned to her group. And three, work for the entire organization. We're now going to take a look at another user screen. And this person is also has a very fortunate name, which is UW Connect Lite Admin. This is the person who in the event management organization can carry out some basic administrative functions, such as creating categories that can be used for tickets. Here, she's creating a category called routing. And then if there's a ticket, the category is called reporting, and future tickets can have that category. She's now going to add a member to one of the assignment groups. This is actually done via UW IT's group service, which then syncs to UW Connect. You can see that Heidi has been added via the group service, and then when the sync is completed in UW Connect, and we take a look at the group record, we can see that Heidi is now added as a group member. And if Heidi didn't previously have access to UW Connect Lite as a licensed user, she'll now start consuming a license. The final perspective we are going to look at is Lisa's perspective. So we're looking at her My Requests page, and this page shows all active issues but being managed by a UW Connect service provider. And that's whether it's a UW Connect Lite provider, UW Connect service management, such as UW IT, or case management, which is handled by the Integrated Service Center. Lisa can find her issues by sorting the description. She can sort the organization. And she can even take a look at closed records. Now, if you recall, Faizan actually resolved her earlier ticket. When a ticket is resolved, it actually can be edited for up to 5 days after resolution. After that, it goes to an inactive state. Even though Faizan thought that he had resolved Lisa's issue, she still has some outstanding questions. You can see here that she's putting information in via the My Requests page, and she's telling him that she needs some additional information about records retention policy, and she'd actually like to talk to Faizan. So what will happen is once she clicks on send, this ticket is actually now going to go back to in progress, and then Faizan and the assignment group will receive a notification that the ticket has been reopened. Some of the benefits of UW Connect Lite. So it is a central repository for current and historical custom requests, and that can be very useful. One, for keeping things out of email, which really supports multiple team members supporting the same customers. It also allows your customers to request assistance through multiple channels. So of course they can call you on the phone and one of your agents can create a ticket from scratch, but you also get an inbound email address, which will, as we saw in this example, auto-generate a ticket and assign it to a default assignment group. Additionally, you'll have access to a web form that you can publish as another mechanism for input. You can publish that web form any place you'd like. Only authenticated users can fill out the web form. So we've seen that your team members then have a mechanism for managing their work. They've got easy visibility into their workload via those dashboards, and your leadership has visibility into current and historical workloads. So overall, UW Connect Lite really supports repeatable processes and customer communications, and your ticket templates and knowledge articles serve as a very valuable tool on that front. Thank you for attending this demonstration. And you can check out more information on IT Connect, or you can send a request to help at uw.edu with UW Connect Lite in the subject line. Thanks, and have a nice day.